Brendan Collins is here with more information. Thanks so much for coming in this
sure.
morning. That is, it's a weight lifted off of women. I mean, you said that's when they have large breasts like that, it's like carrying around
yes, it's
weights.
It's like carrying around a 3-pound weight around your neck, and mm-hmm. when you remove that, the result is pretty amazing for patients.
Mm-hmm. The good news is that insurance will cover this most times.
Oftentimes they do. There are some arbitrary criteria that insurance companies have, but by and large, if it's the right patient, it's usually covered.
Mm-hmm. And at what age, what's the earliest age you can do this surgery?
Generally, late teens. Mm-hmm. You want to make sure that the breasts are done developing, mm-hmm. obviously. Some younger patients benefit just as much as older patients.
Right, right. And is it a painful surgery?
Generally not. We do it on an outpatient basis. Mm-hmm. We're able to use these very nice pain catheters that last about 5 days that mm-hmm. really help to take the edge off of the discomfort.
Are there certain people who are better candidates than others?
Well, you want to make sure that the surgery is safe. Mm-hmm. So smoking is a definite no-no for breast reduction. Mm-hmm. Type 1 diabetes can also be a risk factor for wound healing problems. Mm-hmm. But you also want to make sure the patients have kind of optimized all of their conservative care in this, and that they've lost weight.
Okay.
Weight loss, exercise, physical therapy, those are pretty much the main areas that you want to optimize.
Okay, and I guess we should mention that if you have the surgery and you gain weight, you can often gain it back where you
yes,
have a reduction.
Yes, so this is, there's some maintenance mm-hmm. involved in mm-hmm. this as well. You've got to take care of yourself after the surgery.
All right, but overall, people should investigate it if it's something that's been bothering them.
Yes, yep.
All
These
right.
tend to be our happiest patients.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Collins. Mm-hmm.